Hello, I'm Elaine Mills, one of the coordinators here at the Glen Carlin Library Community Garden in Arlington, Virginia. Today, I'd like to introduce you to two shrubs which are putting on quite a show here in late September. They are Japanese Beautyberry, Calicarpa japonica, and our native American Beautyberry, Callicarpa Americana. Let's go take a look. Here in the Asian garden is a Japanese Beautyberry, Callicarpa japonica. It's also native to China, Korea, and Taiwan. This particular plant is quite a specimen. It has these arching, fountaining branches. It grows about 3 to 7 feet high. And because it blooms on new wood, it can be pruned back fairly severely, down to maybe even 6 inches in height late winter or early spring. Taking a closer look, we'll see these pairs of leaves along the arching branches. They are lance-shaped, and they range in length from about 3 to 5 inches at most. The berries, which are the beautiful feature right now, are arranged in tight little clusters that are along the top edge of the branch. As you see here, the fruit is just beginning to ripen, ripening from green to this beautiful dark purple. The flowers, the pollinated flowers from which this fruit developed, are pale pink in color, not very noticeable. They will appear in June and July, and again, they're arranged in small clusters along the top edge of the branches. Here we are in our native plant garden to take a closer look at American Beautyberry, Callicarpa americana. This plant has a vase shape to it with very open arching branches. It also can reach about 3 to 6 feet in height. And like the non-native species, it can be pruned back severely if you wish in order to have fuller branching and fuller fruiting. I've brought a branch of the Japanese Beautyberry here to this plant for comparison. First of all, you'll notice that the leaves of the native plant are significantly larger and different in shape. They can range up to 9 inches in length, and rather than being lance-shaped, they really are more ovate, more oval, although they do end with a pointed tip. The fruit is very different. It's a brighter color, more of a magenta color, and as you'll note, it completely surrounds the branch rather than ranging just along the top surface the way the Japanese species does. And the flowers similarly cluster very tightly, very densely around the entire branch. Now, a very interesting thing that I've just learned about the leaves of the American Beautyberry is that historically, cowboys and farmers in the South would crush these leaves and place them under the harnesses of their horses to ward off biting insects. And recently, certain compounds have been extracted from the leaves of this plant. One of them, calicarpinol, has been discovered might also be used as an insect repellent and a potential replacement for DEET. Both of the Beautyberry shrubs are very attractive and could be enjoyed as ornamental plants in our gardens, but I would personally choose the native species. First of all, who can resist this amazing show of the colorful berries in such dense clusters? Secondly, this plant is going to provide wonderful services to our wildlife. The summer blooming flowers offer nectar to pollinators, and this fruit is enjoyed by over 40 species of songbirds, including robins, cardinals, towhees, and mockingbirds. My colleague Alyssa even caught a juvenile catbird feeding recently on the berries.